Hi guys, and welcome to another video of Lena's Hands. Today I am going to be making stuffed potato balls, which in Spanish they're called relleno de papa. I'm using ground turkey, but you're more than welcome to use ground beef, ground chicken to stuff them. And I'm also going to be putting cheese. This is the first time for me to put cheese in it, so this is something that I'm going to be trying right along with you guys. So you'll need about 4 to 5 large potatoes, peel and mashed up, like as if you're going to be doing mashed potatoes. The only difference is you're not going to be adding butter or milk. You're just going to be mashing the potatoes and adding salt and pepper for taste. Okay, and we'll be back when I get that all done. Okay, we're back, guys. So once the potatoes are done cooked and you have them mashed up, okay, just have them mashed up really good. I'm gonna try to do another once over. Okay, now put that up. Okay, I only add salt and pepper to the potato mix. The mashed potatoes, okay? Just a little bit, because the meat that you're gonna put in the middle of it is going to be seasoned, so you don't want to season it over, make it too salty. Okay. It would help if I had the salt here. Okay. Just give it a couple turns of that. Okay. And then you want to give it a little whirl, mix up the salt and pepper. Okay. Yeah, don't pay attention to that. It's broke. Yeah, no. It's all right. Okay. So, all right. Now, after that, one egg. Okay. Right in there. Okay. And just mix it up. Try not to make too much of a mess. Okay. Alright. How about I just grab another different type of utensil? Here we go. Ta-da! My spatula. Okay, dry that. Okay. Right. Okay, just gonna use this. And then you want to get, because what you're making is like a potato dough for your balls. Okay. And let's see, mix that up really good. Alright. Now I see it's gonna get clean, don't worry about it. So what I do is, let me get that so I don't contaminate anything else. What I'm going to do, because I see a couple clumps, I'm going to just remash a couple things. A couple of the potatoes that I see. And you can do that as well if you see some in there. Because sometimes, you know, the older we get, our eyesight tends to go a little bit. So, yeah. Okay. All right. Okay, here we go. Should be good. All right. Okay. Let's stir it up. And then you want to add 1 tablespoon of cornstarch. Okay. Just to help it to come together. And thicken it up as well. And that's what you want. Yeah, new box. Sorry, guys. Okay. Okay, like a tablespoon. Heaping. Okay. You specify that. Put that in there. And then you just want to stir this up, mix it up real good. Okay. See how it's like, because I had stuck the egg in there. Tablespoon. Yeah, sometimes don't always grab the right utensils to use, okay? Not perfect. All right. Let's give it a nice little stir. We'll whip. Get all that cornstarch together. Make sure it's incorporated really good. Okay, you see no cornstarch, little dry patches in there or anything. See? This is kind of what you're looking for. Okay. Okay. All right. So, now that that is all pretty good, okay, and what you're going to do is you're going to cover this up with saran wrap, okay, and put it in the refrigerator for 30 minutes, okay, and then once that is, your 30 minutes is done, we'll be back, and I'll show you the next step. Okay, guys, we're back. Now, we're getting ready to, I'm getting ready to cook my meat for the stuffed potato balls, okay. I have Jennie-O's ground turkey. You can use ground chicken or ground beef, and this is about a pound. I totally forgot I had this pan on, but I have it down on medium heat. So we're gonna get ready to cook this, okay? Cut this real quick, okay. All right, my hands are clean, guys, okay? Oh, and I have about a tablespoon of olive oil in this pan. You also want to cut up a small onion, dice it up, little pieces, okay? Crumble it up, like it's a little frozen, just a tad bit. Okay, while that's in there cooking, I'm going to defrost it a little bit. Actually, sorry guys. I'm gonna let you know the seasonings that I use to season my turkey. Some say that ground turkeys, you know, you gotta add a whole lot of salt and all that. No, you really don't. You just have to add certain seasonings together to give it that flavor that you're maybe looking for. You may be looking for something spicy, salty, or even taco-ish. I don't know. Whatever floats your boat that night. So, yes, that's my oven for my biscuits. Yes, I'm cooking dinner as well, guys. Okay. All right. So, let's see if this is broken up a little bit. It's not. I have to flip it. Okay. A little bit. Take some of that cooked meat off. Well, it's not cooked, but you know, it's getting there. Okay. Pick it up a little bit. I don't know why. It's not. It's been out. It's all stained. Just a little bit, guys. Just a little bit. Just a little bit. But you know, you get the hint. You just break it up, like, you know, little crumble pieces. Okay, I'm just gonna let this cook for a minute, and we'll be back. Okay, now my meat is broken up and defrosting. So my cup of onion, my small onion that I have diced up, I'm gonna throw it in there too. Yes, while the meat is cooking. Yes, judge your mama. This is how I've been cooking it. So, yeah, that's how I like to do it. Okay, put that in there. Sofrito. This is who I like to get down with. Okay, this is called, I can't even read it. You see what that's called. Okay, now I use about, I'm gonna tell you. This is about 3 tablespoons of sofrito. Boom. Let it cook for about good 5 minutes. Okay. Oh, also, your seasonings. I have all my seasonings in this little bowl here. I have black pepper, 2 packets of sazon, 1 tablespoon of adobo, 1/4 teaspoon of cayenne pepper. I also have, what else did I use? I use Italian seasonings and parsley flakes. I want to tell you to season it to your liking, to your taste. Because some people will say, oh, that's too salty, that's too much salt, that's too much spice. Season it how you like to season it, okay? The little mixture that I made, I'm going to sprinkle it on top of my turkey, and I'm going to taste it once it's cooked. If I feel as though it needs more seasoning, I'll add more seasoning to it. You can do the same as well, and we'll be back once the meat is all done. Okay guys, we're back. Now you want to take your potato dough once it's been out of the refrigerator for a few seconds, okay, and you want to get like a nice little small, kind of like the size of a golf ball right now. You take it and you want to pat it down, okay, in the we'll make a little cup. Okay. Kind of looks like this. See? See what I mean? Okay. Now, I'm putting cheese. Shredded cheese. You don't have to do it. I'm doing it because I want to try something new. But originally, you can put your meat in there. I'm putting about a tablespoon of the meat. Okay, it's like that. Okay, then you want to close it slowly, like just to cover it up. Okay, kind of work with it. Close it up. Okay, and while I'm doing this, I have the pan on with vegetable oil. I have it halfway and I have it on medium heat. Okay, warming up now. I want to try to cover it up. I'm going to put just a little bit. The good thing about the potato dough, like if you feel like you kind of put too much meat in there, you can get a little bit of the potato and kind of top it up. Because what you want to do is you want to form it into a ball. Okay. Now, I have a bowl over here with cornstarch, and you want to lightly. Let's see if I can show you. I'm kind of working on my little counter here. I have a bowl here with cornstarch. A little messy right now, okay? And then what you do is you want to sprinkle a little bit on top and kind of roll it around in your hand and form it into a ball. Okay, like this. Okay, don't worry about the excess. Okay, just go like this with it. Okay, then I'm gonna put it in the pan, in this plate here. Okay, I have one done already. Okay, and then you can get some more dough. Okay. Can get about, yeah, like I said, like a golf ball size, or if you like to make them bigger because you may have your big boys or whatever, the men in your house that like the filling, like the how can you say, the men in the house that like to, you know, eat the meat and potatoes, you know, those type of men. Okay, you want to make a little indentation here. A little pocket is what I should call it. Okay, now I'm going to make one without the cheese. So I'm going to add the meat in here. Okay, now and put it in there, and then you see, and close it up. And work away to cover it up, to close it up. Okay. Yes, it's a little messy to do, but I'm trying to tell you, the finished product is banging. It's delicious. Okay. Now my pan here is a little hot. I feel the heat coming off of it. Okay. And then once you have it, you form it up. Okay. See? Little ball. And then you take your cornstarch, just sprinkle a little bit. And if your hands are right, oh, some got in the pan. It's okay. It's okay. I don't have too much counter space, so we're kind of working with what I got. So, okay. All right. I'm going to put that there. I'm going to have to move this pan. Okay. And we'll be back. Okay, guys, we're back. Now, I'm going to show you again how to do these balls. I feel like I didn't show you the right way. Okay. Now, before you get started, you have clean hands. Okay. Your bowl of cornstarch. You take your cornstarch, put it on your hand just to have a little bit on your hand. Okay. You get your potato ball, a little bit, okay, the dough, okay, put it on your hand, flatten it down a little bit, just flatten it enough to where you have like a little cup, so you can make a little pocket to put your meat in, okay, gonna make another one without the cheese, okay, gonna take some meat, okay, gonna put some in there. A good tablespoon, okay. Work it to close it, okay. To close it up, okay. Turn it, close it up, okay. Okay, close it up, form it into a ball, okay. Then you take the cornstarch again and you sprinkle some on it. Enough, okay, then you just you form your ball, okay, and there you have it, okay, and it's ready to be fried, okay, so I'm going to continue rolling the other ones, and then we'll be back when it's time to fry them, okay. Okay, guys, we're back, and I did a few ahead, and I am getting ready to take the ones that I have in this pan out already. Okay, and I will show you the ones that we are going to get ready to fry. Okay, this is a ball. If you can see, but look how much oil I have. So it's like the oil is kind of like halfway to the ball, halfway in the middle where the ball is. Okay, so I'm gonna add another one. Okay, now you can deep fry these too if you have one, and it works about, like, you know, it'll cover the whole thing in the deep fryer, of course. So you want to fry these for about a good, if you're doing a deep fryer, about good 5 minutes. and here 5 to 6 minutes, and then the same thing in the pan, but of course the pan you have to rotate them to cook it on each side, so about 3 minutes on each side, okay, until they're like brown, because remember everything is cooked, you just really want to just fry the outside basically, okay. So we will be back. Okay guys, now we're coming, we're at the end of the video for the stuffed potato balls, and I just want to let you guys know that I want to thank each and everyone that has subscribed to my channel. I appreciate it from the bottom of my heart. I hope to give you guys a bunch of more videos on different things that I like to cook. Different things that I like to do as far as cooking, baking, crafting. We have yet to do any desserts. I have desserts coming up as well as crafts. So with that being said, please like and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already, and come back for future more videos. And here are the potato balls that I made. See how tiny they are? And these are a perfect power snack and everything. Yeah, I know, I got the sty in the eye. It's going away. So, let's see. Delicious. Look. Ooh, and I got the one with the cheese. Really good. I hope you guys try this recipe, and let me know if any other recipes that you guys could think of that you would like for me to make for you guys. Bye bye. They're still frying, and look how they look.